one small formal amendment that needs to be made, and we have put in an IA to that effect. That is my, there has been an amalgamation and therefore a change in status of the petitioners. We brought the IA, Malhotra. I understand that it means.
Oh, this is what? Saurashtra Ferrous Private
Yeah,
Limited.
now it has, Malhotra, it has changed to Saurashtra Fuels. And
No objection to that? IA is there? Is it?
I don't have a copy, but if my learned friend is making a statement, I have no reason to doubt him.
Give a copy to them.
Formal amendment.
Where is the application?
Yes.
Not yet filed.
Look, it was filed yesterday, but it may not be on the court's record.
Senior counsel appearing for the petitioner submitted that what has happened to the earlier one? Amalgamation.
There hasn't been an amalgamation as per page, Malhotra, 2, paragraph 3.
In view of the amalgamation proceedings, the name of the petitioner would have to be now changed to
Saurashtra Fuels
Saurashtra Fuels
Private Limited.
Yes, sir.
Para 3, page 2 of the application.
That an application for seeking substitution has also been filed. Got amalgamated with what?
Malhotra, with the petitioner.
Two companies have been amalgamated with Saurashtra Fuels Private Limited. Saurashtra Infra and Power Private Limited and Saurashtra Ferrous, the appellant.
It's merged into fuels.
Yes, that.
So therefore, Malhotra, as an entity, the petitioner is no longer in existence.
That Saurashtra Ferrous Private Limited, the original petitioner, has been amalgamated with Saurashtra Fuels Private Limited. Full stop. In the circumstances, the application for substitution may be allowed. Full stop. There being no objection to the said application, it is allowed. Appellant's counsel to amend the cause title and file an amended memo of parties. Yes, now.
Yes, so my lords, this is on the interpretation of this incentive scheme which came in, my lords, in after the Kutch earthquake. Now, my lords, broadly, before I hand over the list of dates and take your lordships through the scheme, the issue is this.
What did the court do?
My
Why did
lords,
you file the writ petition?
when did I file, my lords?
Why?
My lords, yes. So, my lord, broadly, what happened is this was a scheme which was in to encourage, my lords, new units to be established in the state of Gujarat. And the idea was new investment comes in, new factories come in, and therefore employment opportunity. Now, my lords, what they did after the cutoff date in terms of, my lord, by 31st December 2005, we were to set up a new unit. Now, as I'll show your lordships the scheme, never once in the scheme do they make it product specific that you will get exemption on the basis of which product you produce by that date. So it was, I had to set up plant and machinery, but what happened was my plant and machinery was very substantially complete. I had started commercial production. But what they later said, much after the cutoff date, and I'll show that that was not even a notified amendment made or a notified clarification. They wrote a letter to the Federation saying that it will be product specific. I'll come to, my lord, the individual facts, your lordship, need not at this stage.
So,
I'm just
it is
broadly pointing out.
an exemption from excise.
Yes, exemption for a period of 5 years. So if you complete, if you set up a brand new unit and you also begin commercial production by the 31st of December 2005, then for a period of 5 years, you will get excise exemption.
What did they do then?
So, my lord, what they introduced a circular, not notified, not gazetted, where they said that we will, it is product specific. So, in other words, only if you, depending on which product, in our case, my lord, we had begun production of cast iron. So they said that we, even though you may say that you have invested, say, 24, 25 crores, which we had in the plant and machinery, we will only give you the exemption way what you have done with cast iron and not for the rest of the, because my point was that, look, I have installed, I have set up this new unit. Your scheme was not concerned with individual products. Your scheme was to ensure that new units.
What are the other products you did? Apart, my lord,
I was to also produce pig iron. So admittedly, my lords, pig iron, I had not commenced production on that date, but my plant and equipment were very substantially, even with that, it was substantially.
So what's the notification?
Yes. So my lords, may I show your lordship the scheme first? And then
the scheme.
So please see my lords, page 38. My lord, may I just read quickly the first paragraph and then the main, what I need to satisfy. In exercise of the powers conferred by subsection so-and-so of the Excise Act, read with so-and-so, the Central Government deems it necessary in the public interest so to hereby exempt the goods specified in the first schedule to the Central Excise Tariff Act, other than goods specified in the annexure appended to the notification and cleared from a unit located in Kutch district of Gujarat from so much duty of excise or the additional duty of excise, as the case may be. My lord, it should be leviable thereon under any of the acts as is equivalent to the amount of duty paid by the manufacturer of goods other than the amount of duty by utilization of SENVAT credit under the SENVAT credit rules. Now, my lords, please see, provided that in case of a unit having an original value of investment in plant and machinery installed in the factory below rupees 20 crores on the date of commencement of commercial production in the unit, the exemption contained herein shall apply only for the first clearances up to an aggregate value not exceeding twice the
but
value.
There were so many terms and conditions.
Yes. So, my lord, the terms and conditions, your lordship.
You have otherwise satisfied with all the terms and conditions?
My lord, because now they have also accepted that cast iron I definitely was commencing, and in fact, they have cleared that amount. My point is.
The first schedule?
In the schedule.
Yes, yes, that there's no dispute in on that. My lord, there's no dispute. In fact, they have cleared as far as cast iron
is
concerned.
Where is the schedule?
My lord, the schedule is not there. But my lord, that is not in dispute because
they have cleared. Where is the difficulty which arose for
you? So my lord, please come to page 45.
That's annexure is there.
Clause 3.
49.
Clause 3, page 45. The exemption contained in the notification shall be subject to the following conditions, namely, now please see what I'm saying is this is facially neutral on its product name. 45. This is the main clause, my lords. How do I qualify for this exemption? Three, the exemption contained in the notification shall be subject to the following conditions, namely, one, it shall apply only to new industrial units, that is to say, units which are set up on or after the date of publication of this notification in the official gazette, but in my lords, it should be not later than for 31st December 2005.
So when did you set up?
So my lords, I set up my unit well before 31st December. On 31st December, my lords, I was
so
commercial.
For cast iron, they have granted you.
They have granted, but my lord, my point is that your representation to me was that I have to set up a brand new unit and I have to start commercial production. You did not say that it should be goods specific, that only if what you spend
on plant and equipment for a particular set of goods, only that.
Yes.
Where the bar arose for them.
I just want to also, 48 before I turn to that, my lords. I'll come to the circular just in a minute, my lord. 48, please note. My lord, 47, Roman 4 says, 47 says, exemption shall apply for a period not exceeding 5 years from the date of commencement of commercial production by the unit. So no mention that it is going to be goods specific. In other words, suppose I'm producing five sets of color different goods, and I start set two right before 31st December. And then even though I have set up a brand new unit, but my other three goods take a little more time to start. You never said that you will make it goods specific. Once I set up a new unit.
Commercial production by the unit.
Yes, that's the point, my lord. It is by the unit. And my lords, ultimately, please.
Where is that subsequent circular?
Yes. My lords, that is at page 105. And my lords, please, this is very important that please look, it is a letter. It is not even a circular. It is a letter. It is not notified. And this
is
important.
That letter?
105. 25th of April 2006. My lord will note at the center of the page on the top, there is 25th April 2006. So please note, this is about 4 months after my deadline of commercial production. That's number one.
This
secondly,
Ministry of Finance letter to the Secretary General Federation.
Yes, now that's very important, my lords. I've taken instructions on this. I was not
on
even
the representation made by the Federation.
Now
of Industries.
I'm not even a member of that federation.
What
number
do they
one.
Say?
This is not even addressed to me, and it is not notified. It has to be, my lords. If this is going to be an amendment or a clarification, it should have been gazetted and notified. Please
what did
see.
They say?
Now, my lord, they say. At page 107, please see, 107, top of the page, point 2. Clarification may be issued in respect of unit which started commercial production before 31st December 2005 and starts new product line, which has also been declared at the time of registration of the product after 31-12-2005. Now, this is between the Federation and the government. Please see comments. Benefit of notification number 39 of 2001, only applicable to those new industrial units which commences commercial production before 31st December 2005. In other words, if a new industrial unit is installed after 31st December 2005 and commence commercial production, my lord, it should be after 31st December 2005, then such industrial unit would not be eligible to avail exemption under the said notification. Similarly, if commercial production of a particular kind of specified goods has not commenced, my lord, it should be production before 31st December 2005.
The benefit of the said notification would not be
What is the meaning of a particular kind of specified goods? Where they have specified?
In the incentive scheme, my lord, this is not there. This portion, I am aggrieved
what
by
What is
this.
The meaning of specified goods?
My lord, what we understand is, in our case, for instance, cast iron, I had begun production before 31st December. However, even though I was intending to, and I had set up, there was a substantially complete.
No, where is the specified goods list?
Page 49, goods 49 chapter.
That is annexure.
Who is that chapter?
My lord, these are goods, my lords, which.
Where are the goods?
My lord, these are excluded goods. These are excluded. Am I right? These are
particular kind of specified goods. Where are the specified goods?
Lord, I'll just check that, but that's not a dispute. I'll get that for you.
Huh.
It is not. These are the excluded goods which won't be covered, right? Yes, these are excluded
that
goods.
Annexure is for what?
Lord, the annexure is to specify actually the excluded goods. Have you got the original?
Annexure at page
49. I'm looking at, my lords. These will not qualify at all, and I'm not concerned with any item in this list.
Where is the reference to the annexure in the scheme?
Specified. Please come to page 38.
My lord, 38.
If I exempt the goods specified in first CD to the Central Excise Tariff Act.
Yes.
I also
understand the schedule.
Your good has to fall under these.
Yeah, my lord, that is, I'll show, my lord, we'll get that, but it's not in dispute. This is not a dispute.
No, we'll see that. What is that list?
Because, yes, I appreciate that. Please get the excise schedule.
No, what is this?
My lord, this
is the reference to the annexure in the scheme.
My lord, at 49.
Exempts the goods specified 49. In the first schedule. Exempts the goods specified in the first schedule to the Tariff Act. Other than goods specified in the annexure.
My lord, I've
hereby exempts.
My lord, I'll just indicate to your lordships that
other than the goods specified in the annexure appended to this notification and cleared from a unit. So and so. If any good falls within the annexure, then they are not entitled to it.
Yes, we are not. But we are not concerned, my lord. We don't fall. We don't fall
within.
In fact, I'll just indicate, my lord, even subsequently, insofar as cast iron is concerned.
So you're a good falling under the schedule. There is no dispute about it.
My lord, there's no dispute about it, but we'll get the schedule. We should get the schedule. Right. Because, my lord, they have actually cleared it with cast iron.
Central Excise Tariff Act 1985.
I'm sorry.
So what happened? So therefore, when they were answering the query
of the Federation, with to which I'm not a party, my lords, they say they introduced this new, at 107, they introduced this new condition that to 4 months after my commercial production was to start and did start.
No, therefore, we are coming here. Similarly, if the commercial production of a particular kind of specified goods
has not commenced.
My God, what type?
I'm sorry about that, my lords.
It reads.
Has not commenced.
4/31/12.
Yes.
There again, the benefit of the said notification
would not be available to such goods. So for the very first time, my lords, after the cutoff date has gone by, they are introducing a new condition which makes it good.
No, see, ultimately, in paragraph 38, page 38, what it says is, exemption is for the goods specified. Exemption is now for what?
Of course.
For the goods.
It can only be goods. Yes, yes.
Not for the industrial unit. It is for the goods. Now, if the goods are within the specified list of the Act, you are entitled to exemption, provided the goods are produced before 31/12/2005.
No, my lord.
It is not. If you read 38,
yes,
the preamble,
yes,
it is not with regard to exemption. Is not for the unit as a whole.
No, excise exemption can only be
good specific.
Yes, my lord.
So
it has
it is
to be
good specific.
So, my lord, may I just explain? There is excise can only be applicable for goods, naturally. Number two, my lords, but we are concerned with an incentive scheme. The incentive is what? That you set up a new unit. If you set up a new unit, then, and you start commercial production by a particular date, commercial production, not qua particular goods or say 5 goods or 10 goods, but you start commercial production. If you start commercial production, then we give you that exemption for a period of 5 years. That is after. So, my lords, what we are saying is that this new introduction.
But here they have also given the explanation, the expression set up on or after the date of publication of this.
My lord, sorry, which page is my
page 48.
Yes.
They have given some explanation to this setup.
Yes.
On or after. Please read that.
Yes.
This
notification, a change in the name or nature of ownership. My lord, we are not concerned with this. The expression set up on or after the date of publication of this notification in the Office Gazette, but late. It should be not later. Not later than 31st December 2005 shall mean that any civil construction work on its factory premises and any installation of plant and machinery therein commences only on or after the date of publication of this notification in the official gazette and the said's civil construction on its factory and premises and installation of plant and machinery therein is completed and the unit starts commercial production not later than the 31st day of December 2005. The point is, and my lords, if your lordships looks at this along with 45, please, my lord, 45 is very important.
Please read 45. Yeah.
My lords, 3-1, I'm sorry.
Not, my lord.
In yes, yes, that is correct. I think it's just very poor typing. I'm extremely sorry.
45 and 48.
That is right. My learned friend is right. 3-1.
It shall apply.
My lord, yes. So please see, my lord, may I read it with the top of 3. The exemption contained in the notification shall be subject to the following condition, namely, it shall apply only to new industrial units, that is to say units which are set up on or after the date of publication of this notification in the official gazette, but not later than 31st December. So, my lord, what I'm saying is this. The whole focus and purpose of this scheme was you please set up a new unit and I will then exempt you so long as you start commercial production by a particular date. I will give you exemption for a period of 5 years, whatever you produce in those 5 years. So that then, of course, the calculation of exemption will be good specific. But when I am entitled to avail of it, my lords, depends on general commercial production, not on good specific commercial production. That is the distinction which I am drawing and which is a new condition introduced by a letter, my lords, a letter to the Federation, which may not have even written unless the Federation themselves had written. I'm not a member of the Federation. This was never addressed to me. And my lords, therefore,
so ultimately, only, what did they do?
They rejected my, my lords.
Where is that order?
Yes. So my lord, the rejection is at page 157. My lords, I have yet not shown my lords because there was some controversy whether I produced cast iron or not, but that was settled.
Cast iron, you're not concerned. You're only concerned with
pig iron. Yes, because now
they
cleared that also. Yes, 157. Please see 157.
What did they write?
Yes. So, my lords, they said 158, your lordships will see. Please refer to the application dated so-and-so for issue of certificate referred in para 3 of the notification dated 31-7-2001. I have taken your lordships through that. In the application, it was intimated that commercial production shall start from 30th December 2005, that the following excisable products would be manufactured. So these are excisable products, iron and steel, pig iron, cast iron production, duct from iron steel, so-and-so, so-and-so. Further, my lords, please see below. Further, the total value of plant and machinery installed were declared at ₹2,430 lakhs. Vide subsequent letter dated 9-1-2006, addressed to the Assistant Commissioner Central Excise and Customs Bhuj, it was confirmed that commercial production was started on 30th December 2005. Assistant Commissioner Bhuj visited the unit on 2-1-2006, reported that unit was still under construction and erection installation. Foundation was in progress, that blast furnace blower home cast house was not installed, that there were no conveyor belts and no pig casting machines, that the production from mini cupola of some molten casting iron approximately...
You have said pig iron was not manufactured.
Yes.
Before 30...
That is correct. That is factually correct. But cast iron was.
Cast iron you have received.
Yes, but my lords, my, therefore, the this is on the ground on which they have rejected my... Was shown commercial production that the same was not declared in the registration.
See, the whole idea was that because of the earthquake in
set
2001,
up
investments were necessary. So they said, all right, we will grant you this five-year exemption. Five-year exemption commenced when?
My lords, 2005.
From?
2005 to 10, 5 years.
2005 to 2010. Ten. If within 31-12-2005, you had set up the plant and machinery and there was production also.
Commercial production by a particular.
Yes. You're entitled to it.
Lord, I set now, up a for... new plant. I set up a new plant correct. And I start commercial production.
Now, not only a setting up of a new plant, there has to be a commercial production also.
Correct.
Commercial production means what? Commercial production of the products.
Now, any product.
Products. You have commenced, no doubt, the commercial production by 31st December 2005 of cast iron. Now, for whatever reason, additional machinery was required, that particular machinery was required, you had to import, there has been a delay in the import, you did not commence the production of pig iron before 31-5.
That is correct.
31-12-2005.
That's correct.
You may get it after 2 years. Your machinery may have been got stuck in the customs.
Right.
You started only in 2007 or 8.
Suppose, my lord, yes.
That's it. Therefore, for that particular product, it is disallowed. You are allowed for what you had produced before 31-12.
So, my lord, may I
know? No doubt your unit is set up.
My lord is right. But now, my lord, let me just take that argument forward. Obviously, my lord, when you calculate excise and therefore an exemption on that excise, it will have to be on goods which are manufactured. So if they are manufactured in 2007, in 2008, anytime up to 2010, the question is, will I get exemption on that? Now, my lords, in this case, therefore, I'm not saying that you give me exemption on pig iron, which I have not produced in, say, 2005 or 2006. I'm not saying that. I am saying qualify me under the scheme because I started commercial production.
No, but you are already qualified. You are getting it for cast iron exemption. Lords,
I also have to get it for... My lords, please see, the issue
is... We gave you this example. Your import of machinery is got stuck with the customs.
Took
you right up to Supreme Court. You may have come 2 years.
Right.
Customs duty dispute.
Right, right.
Start the production in 2008.
Right.
Obviously, that you see that specified.
It's item, not excisable because it's not manufactured.
No. Not that. Question is, even though if it is within 2010. You have not done it within 31st December 2005.
So that's the whole question.
See, the period of the scheme is 5 years. But to be eligible,
correct,
your production must be before 31st December 2005.
Yes.
Of the specified item.
No, my lord, that is...
Page 38. Pig iron is a specified item. Cast iron is a specified item. Cast iron you have produced before 31st 12. But pig iron you have not produced before 31-12. Your eligibility for pig iron is not there.
So, my lord, may I just...
It is specified item.
May I... No, so, my lord, may I just address...
What did the High Court say?
No, the High Court is relying on another judgment called Plasteen, where that particular, my lord, circular was, my lord, not under challenge at all. That particular circular of my lord 25-4-2006.
What is the relief you got ultimately?
Lord, I didn't get relief because they partially in the sense that I could apply quick cast iron.
With regard to pig iron, it was rejected.
So it was
with regard to
paragraph 13, my lords.
Page 15, your ladyship will have, my lord.
Yes, 16, 17.
Of the finding. We had rejected their contention. The High Court has allowed for
cast iron.
For cast iron, saying commercial production, very small quantity, less than 1 metric ton, had started.
Sir, I'll just
explain. No, why we are telling you this is,
yes,
we are taking sustenance from page 38.
Yes, my lord.
Which says, where is that 38?
Yes, 38 is the beginning of my scheme.
Yes, yes. Where? It is with regard to exemption is for goods specified.
So may I elaborate, explain.
Production of pig iron was before 31-12-2005. You would have been entitled to that also.
No, that's what they are saying. Now, Mala, may I address your lordship on that?
Good specific.
No, may I address your lordship on that? So, my lord, sorry, my lord is saying something.
That's all.
I don't want to short circuit my learned submission, but their own CEO, chief executive officer, has made a statement before the authorities, which is noticed even in the order of 2007 at page 159, that commercial production for pig iron.
I'm not contesting that.
Admittedly, it is after that date.
My argument is a little different, Malad.
Now you're saying even if I'm after that date.
No, not now.
You're saying even if the pig iron was produced after.
A little that, after.
Even after that, since my unit was established.
And my commercial production of any product.
Of a cast iron was there.
Right.
Therefore, you give it for pig iron also.
Malala, it'll take me
that is your to, argument.
Yeah, so, Malala, may I just explain in response to what had fallen earlier from my laws? Now, there is no doubt that naturally excise is on goods.
Specified goods.
Right. We are not on excise so much as an exemption from excise. Right. This incentive scheme is offering us exemption from excise for a period of 5 years. So, obviously, whenever
you're saying your production was within that 5 years, in other words.
No. My Lord. That
it is beyond the cutoff date. But within the period of 5 years.
So, my Lord, therefore, the question arises as to what I need to do to be eligible under this scheme as a whole. My Lord, my submission is on reading of the scheme, what is the focus? The focus and the object is not, please produce 10 goods or 20 goods or 30 goods. That's not the object. The object is to set up new factories, new plants, new enterprise. So, therefore, for that, I have to set up a brand new plant.
That otherwise, you have done, you are getting the cast iron.
In an old factory, I had started 20 new products, which I could have done.
No, that is not, we are
I
not on
not
that.
Get anything.
You are eligible now, already you are eligible for cast iron.
Right.
Because you have produced that before 31-12-2005.
So, I am saying this, that you never in your scheme once said, that it has to be product, the commercial production has to be goods specific.
It is your, specified goods.
So, my lord, excise is on specified goods. Excise incidence is on specified goods. Because there's no other measure. There's no other measure. But my lord, my point is this, that in order to obviously.
Shows the order of rejection.
Yes.
Come
so that is, my lords, at page 157. I just started reading it. My lord, my point is your focus itself in the scheme was you set up a new plant. And if I started commercial production, that's how I showed you that.
See, you have already said blast furnace was not ready.
Yes,
manufacturer of pig iron was later.
Correct. But my plant was ready. My lord, please see 162.
Which specified in the first schedule? They say,
well, please see 162.
Said,
9, the reasons are given.
Yes.
The original value of plant and machinery installed and commercial production as on 31-12-2005 is 96.36 lakhs against declared original value of plant and machinery of rupees 24.3 crores as on 29-12.
Now you got for the 5 years the exemption for cast iron?
Well, they have issued a certificate to that effect. Yes.
So you have got some relief at least.
No, I have not accepted. My lord, 24 crores I set up believing this scheme, which never specified.
No, now this 162, 163.
Yes.
There has been a modification made by the High Court. And they said that insofar as cast iron is concerned, the relief has to be given. Correct?
No, because according to...
They had totally rejected your application.
My lord, no, my lords. Please see 162. Please see 162. What they said is, my lord, they've referred to this figure of 96.36 lakhs.
No, please go to 162.
Yes, I'm on 162, my lord. Please see A. The original value of plant and machinery installed and commercial production as on 31st December 2005 is 96.36 yes. lakhs. Against, now this is what was spent specifically on machinery, quay, the cast iron, right?
Against. No, here they said by this A and B.
Yes.
They said you're not at all eligible for any exemption.
Yes. But they admit that 96.36 lakhs.
So this you questioned in the High Court.
And then, my lord, it is
what
said.
What is the date of this order?
My lord, this is 12-4-2007.
12-4-2007.
Right. And thereafter, my lords, I filed my writ petition, which is at page 164 to 2001, to 201. And then comes.
So this, you challenged this 12-4-2007.
I challenged this, this, and I challenged that so-called circular, which is only a letter.
Now, ultimately, it is held that you're entitled to?
I'm entitled to only quay cast iron.
Have they complied with that?
Lord, they have issued a certificate, but I just want to articulate my argument with that.
No, they have issued the certificate.
Yes, they have. They have. What is the date of this? No, it's not on record, but we have it here.
It's 13th November.
13th November 2014, my lords. 14. My lord, they followed a judgment of the High Court called Plastine, in which...
Yes. See, ultimately, if you see page 38... the exemption is for the goods.
My lord, may I just
the come? Goods have to be manufactured by 3112. And the duty, exemption of duty is to the manufacturer of the goods other than the amount of duty paid
right.
by utilization of Senvat credit under the Senvat credit rules.
So may I
there has to be a holistic reading of this.
Yes, yes.
The exemption is on the duty of excise. Now that what is the duty of excise you pay? That is clarified by duty paid by the
manufacturer
of goods.
Correct, my lord. And no dispute, no dispute. My lord, just give me 2 or 3 minutes to articulate what I really want to say.
No, you have articulated it very well. We have understood the point.
No, my point is
now
this,
my lord. See, they totally rejected your application by not...
I got partial relief.
Partial relief? I think that is... correct.
My lord, may I just give me just a couple of minutes to just, my lord, at least my conscience also will be satisfied on this.
You have explained everything very well. I don't think
my lord, the exemption can only be naturally of what arises between, say, 2006 and for a period of 5 years. It can only be on that naturally.
No, it can't be. It can't extend beyond 2010.
10 for 5 years, I said, my lord. I said 5 years.
5 to 10.
Yes, so up to 2010 is my cutoff.
But there is a condition. Provided the investment comes immediately within
2031. May I say that? Investment of 24.3 crores
has come. We have learned CDA Council and learned Council for the respondent extensively. We are not inclined to interfere with the matter. SLP is hence dismissed.
Obliged.